Next, we have poster 69, factors associated with selected maternal and fetal outcomes among mothers with gestational diabetes mellitus delivering at two selected tertiary care maternity hospitals in Colombo. The authors are Vikram Arachi, WATK, and Samara Nayaka, DBDL. The presenting author is Vikram Arachi, WATK.
Good morning to all of you. Our study was regarding factors associated with selected maternal fetal neonatal outcomes among mothers with gestational diabetes mellitus delivering at two selected tertiary care maternity hospitals in Colombo. As we all know, similar to the other non-communicable diseases in Sri Lanka, the prevalence of gestational diabetes mellitus is also increasing. Therefore, we conducted this descriptive cross-sectional study among mothers diagnosed with gestational diabetes mellitus according to the NICE guideline 2015. There we recruited 265 mothers from postnatal wards of these hospitals. Our sampling method was consecutive sampling, and there we used interviewer administered questionnaire and a data extraction sheet to collect data. When we turn in our results, in this tables you can see cesarean section, placenta previa and pregnancy induced hypertension were common among the maternal complications. Regarding the fetal and neonatal complications, macrosomia, polyhydramnios, respiratory distress and neonatal jaundice showed higher prevalence among fetal and neonatal complications. All these complications significantly associated with poor glycemic control. With regards to the associated factors, most of the socio-demographic factors did not show any association with maternal or fetal complication. But only increased maternal age more than 35 years and excess weight gain during pregnancy was significantly associated with presence of one or more maternal complications. Then with regards to the fetal and neonatal complications, poor compliance to the medical nutrition therapy, exercises and drugs, less than 90% of the compliance level were taken into this study as poor compliance. And poor attendance to field clinics, educational sessions and excess weight gain during pregnancy were significantly associated with presence of one or more fetal or neonatal complications. So in conclusion, we identified poor glycemic control, poor utilization of health services and poor compliance as associated factors with both maternal and fetal neonatal complications. Thank you.
Paper is open for discussion.
So what is your final recommendation for, I mean, in general, based on your findings?
We should recommend all the pregnant mothers should attend to the field health services, and they should maintain a good compliance, and they should have a ideal glycemic control throughout their antenatal period to prevent these maternal and fetal neonatal complications.
So are these maternal and fetal neonatal complications more prevalent among gestational diabetes mothers with gestational diabetes compared to the general population?
Yes, sir. In the previous studies also, we saw that trend. In this with these results also, these complications, especially this neonatal jaundice, was very significantly associated with poor glycemic control among these mothers.
So, based on your study, now you said that, I mean, NCD, just like the way that NCD incidence is rising, the maternal diabetes also is rising. And along with that, we need to assume that all these complications are also rising.
Yes, madam. That is the that should be the usual trend. So, but this is a cross-sectional study. I can't predict on the trend. We have to go on for further studies to identify that trend in Sri Lanka. Thank you.
Thank you. Please give a round of applause.